today is going to be legs. Now, I know that it looks like there's a lot here and that you need a lot of equipment, but you absolutely don't. Half of this stuff on here is just extra. So,
hi.
Hi, hello.
What's going on?
It looks a lot. All you do need really is one bench, some challenging kettlebells, and a weighted bar or some dumbbells.
What are we doing?
We are doing legs.
Ooh.
So it looks like there's a lot going on. So let me just explain how this is going to work today. Lisa is going to start with the cardio. So if you want to follow and start with Lisa, she gets to start with jump overs on the step board. This is why you only really need.
If you've got it, you can use that.
Yeah, this is why we only need one step board, one board if you've got one. It's just that we've got two here, so I'm going to use two. I'm going to take you through the weighted part of our circuit today, of our workout, okay? We're going to start with heavy weighted step ups on the step. Again, if you haven't got a step, you can use your step board, okay?
Chair.
Anything. As long as it's stable and it can hold your weight, you can use it. It's just that we've got it in today, so I've got a treatise.
Why have we got two step boards?
And use it. Because we're going to do some really heavy goblet squats.
Oh, nice.
All the things.
Yeah.
So we have got 50 seconds of work. I'm going to give a 15 second rest. Again, God, a 15 second rest. That is because we're going to work with heavy weights. So I want you to have a tiny bit longer to get yourself in your position so you're not doing any twisting through anywhere where you shouldn't. I don't need any injuries, but I do want you to make sure that you're ready to go when that time starts again.
You might need your straps.
Yeah,
this one.
You need some chalk, you're going to need your straps, and you're definitely probably going to want to use your belt.
Oh, yeah, if you've got your belt,
that's a good idea.
Yeah. Use your belt. So, 7 exercises, 4 times through. This is going to be brutal, I'm not going to lie. This is going to be brutal, but I love legs. I love training legs. I love training my clients with legs, glutes, inner thighs, outer thighs, hamstrings, quads, all of it.
What's the bar for?
The bar is so we've got weighted step ups.
Oh, but you can use your kettlebells.
You can use kettlebells, you can use dumbbells, you can use a sandbag.
Okay.
Whatever you've got that is going to challenge you and push you, use it.
It's
going to
be horrible.
And we'll see you then. Bye. When we've done it, it's going to be a little bit more because we're going to have a real quick buy-in at the end just to isolate those glutes.
Ass work.
We're
doing ass work at the end.
Just ever so quickly, just to isolate those buns because I do love working.
Trisa's got all the ass.
All the ass. So, just very quickly at the end, so it's all going on. Get yourself ready, grab your water, grab your straps, grab some chalk, get your belt if you want it.
If you don't want to do box jump overs, I know a lot of you not feeling it, I guess skipping is your next option, or pick something that is going to push you. There's a big room here. If we had a lot more space, I would probably do shuttle runs.
Oh God, that'd be nice.
Yeah, if you really want to work, and you've worked training with me before, up and down those stairs. Get up and down those stairs with a bit of extra weight.
That
will wreck you.
High knees,
when you wall. Yeah, no excuses really. The reason we're doing this is because a lot of people are always like, oh, I love to use my boards, and I love to use my bones, can we use it more? Do it, this is what we're doing.
It's true though, isn't it?
It's true though.
But can you just put some more?
Yeah.
We'll put 50 seconds of
it. Yeah,
we'll
whack it all in, get it all in.
You can have it all.
Yeah.
Are we ready?
This is going to be horrible. Please remember, this is one of the biggest fat burning muscles in your body. You don't just burn fat from one area, it comes off all of the body. So if you're working this biggest fat burner to its max, it's not just going to come off your legs, it's not just going to tone your legs, it's going to come off the whole of your body. So that's why I always tell you, just go as heavy as you can always drop down. The main thing with legs is your back. A lot of people feel it in the back because they just do not pull their abs in. If you start to feel it in your back at any point, look at your form, check yourself, or you wreck yourself.
I mean, it's true.
It is true.
I'm ready. I'm pumped.
Not happy about it. Broke my nail halfway down my nail bed. Not happy about it. Keep catching it.
Anyway.
They're used to it. Not happy about it. I'm not gonna lie.
Not happy.
It keeps catching my trousers.
He's gonna annoy me the whole time.
I might have to catch. I might have to miss it.
You're not missing it. So if you were going to start with me, your first weighted exercise are going to be with either dumbbells, kettlebells, a sandbag, whatever it is that you've got. I'm going to use a weighted barbell on my shoulders and we are stepping up alternate legs on this bad boy.
If you're with me, box jump overs or Bosu jump overs or running up the stairs or skipping or whatever you choose to do. But you do not have a rest. This is not a rest.
No.
This is to get your heart rate up there So then when you go into your strength work, you are already in your fat burning zone and you are then pushing even harder. That's where the changes are going to happen. If you're getting on this and just having a step,
yeah, it's not going to work.
It's not going to work.
It's not going to fly.
You're in the
wrong
place.
We're going to see that and we're going to be going,
yeah.
What are you doing?
Yeah.
Get
you're in the wrong place.
No.
Not today.
No.
Are you
not
ready?
Today, Carol.
15 seconds. You're probably going to need some water. You're definitely going to need a towel. I can feel this is going to be horrendous. Teresa loves a good leg day.
I do.
I love a good leg day, but Teresa definitely loves a good leg day.
Make sure if you have got that barbell, it is sat on the hard part of your shoulders, not on your neck. Let it sit on your shoulder blades.
Lovely. Ready?
I mean, it can't feel like I started early because, you know, we're still going to send it to our study with bar.
So you tag us. So you can tag us.
Oh, yeah. Do it. Five. This is going to get real, really
very quickly.
Let's go. Make sure when you're doing these on that step, you are alternating the leg.
Just take your time. First round.
I was trying to look at you then. I'm trying to press my body. Stop it.
44.
When you're doing these step ups, have a look at those knees. Make sure they're not coming in or kicking out. You don't have to do these quickly. You should be able to do it quickly. If you challenge yourself with a decent amount of weight, you should not be able to fit these out quick.
Light on your feet. 20. Chair. 15. Woo. Oh, my quads. Squeeze. Three, two, one.
You can carry on. Then you step, then you step. to do after this. Three, two,
down, one. Don't arch your back when you put those weights down.
Get your breath back. So you're on the other leg. Keep those kickbells on. Make sure your back's flat. Start on the bench. Start on the step board. Take lunge back. Drop the knee. Come back up. Squeeze those glutes under there.
Let's go, let's go. Light on your feet. Light on the board. Agility. Power. Strength. Balance. All happening today. 37. 30 seconds. Come on.
Keep with your momentum. Break it down. Drop the knee. Come back up. Step in and pause. Lunge your back. Make sure you're happy with your balance before you start to drop that knee. Pause.
10.
Burning. grab a bit of water, you shake it off, get ready, get low to start with. Come over.
Even the W's over it. It's over it.
Is it enough already?
It's
been a long week. Make sure that back leg curtsies over. You should feel it on the bum cheek of the leg that is on the step board. That little pause will help to drive that weight into the
core. Not a rest.
Of the leg that is on the step board.
Get your mind right. Come on. Over.
30 seconds. Four.
Woo! Deep.
Oh, you'll find one side can manage so much better than the other. Just get one more rep out, then one more rep out, and then one more rep out.
Woo, 10.
You can have a rest after this. 5, 3, 2.
Ooh, shake it out.
Rest it. Oh, Lord. Grab yourself a drink.
No, I've got to do this yet.
Oh,
you've got to
step up. You're absolutely right. You can nearly grab yourself a drink.
Yeah.
3, 2, let's go.
It's very quiet in here.
It's real. This is real
leg
work.
Leg day is never easy. It's never going to be fun. It's just not. It's always horrible. It's just
30 seconds.
Different levels. Whether it's resistance, whether it's weight, whether it's plyometric, whether it's body weight, it all hurts in different ways. And adding the height of the bench is again a different level for us.
15 seconds.
Dig it. Don't let it beat you.
5.
3, 2,
rest it.
9.
Oh.
I don't want to worry her, but she wants to do this 3 more times. 3 more times. I think we should do it twice.
I do want to do it 3 more times. She's right, I do.
I can't know we work hard on leg days.
I would say the first round's always the worst.
You think?
Second round, you'll be like, I know what's coming. I'm all over you. Third and fourth, I don't know what to tell you. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you.
Oh, my horse cheeks hurt so much today. Okay. Very quickly, because we don't want your heart rate to go down. And also, it's just longer, right?
Back to step ups. If you're with me, we should know what we're expecting now. No surprises.
If you're with me, maybe you want to switch it up to skipping. Maybe you want to switch it up to something else. Maybe you want to do some jogs across the room. Maybe you just want to go.
I get it.
Just going is not an option.
Apparently that's not an option.
So, that's high on the first one.
Yep.
Makes you go, oh God, high. I think it's because it's narrow as well. It takes a while to, but if you put your foot in the middle, it's quite nice.
2, 1, go, not a rest. You've had a rest. You had all of 42 seconds.
Wow.
Don't forget it.
You are welcome.
Make sure when you do these step-ups, you're driving the weight from the foot that is on that step. Take your time. When you step off, try and give yourself a square stance on the floor so your balance is spot on.
Yeah, you don't want any twists in the back. People always hurt their back doing little stupid things like just stepping weird or bending funny. 30 seconds.
Keep your chest up, please. Pin those shoulders back so that bar's got a nice solid shelf. Do you feel like it's driving you down? 10.
I want to literally rip my legs off and throw them across the room.
3, 2, flat on those feet. You know what to expect now. Find your rhythm with this.
Just explain what I'm doing.
Lisa's just changing the battery pack.
Just plugging in the battery.
Because clearly the phone's even finding it tiring today. You've got less than 30 seconds.
Let's start again. Sorry.
Start again. So that was all for free if you were with me. Start with me. That was all for free. Yeah. If you did step off, then you just took a few more. It's alright. Sorry. Let's go. It's technology, isn't it? Dry. It's like extra though. Squats are going to be next. 18. Come on. Let's go. Breathe it out. Power through those legs. 3, 2, 1. I'm sweating now. So Lisa's going to do her jump overs on the boat soon.36 kilos, this kettlebell is. It needs to be challenging, it needs to be heavy. You basically are lucky enough to be using half of your body weight, half of the muscle in your body, which means
20 seconds,
10 kilo, a 12 kilo is not going to do it. Absolutely dripping, Teresa.
Yep.
Woo! 10 seconds. Five, one more. Remember, we only do workouts that we stand by, that we do in the gym. Grab those weights, get yourself ready. Yeah. Tiny pause. So we've got the roll forward. 10. Remember, you can always change this for skipping. I need maybe a jog around your living room. As long as it's hard, it should be to the front when you get to that minute. And you're done. And you're sweating. Move. Don't worry about where you are in the workout. Don't worry about the top of the mountain. Just keep your head down and just keep plowing through every rep the best you can. Before you know it, that rep will be done. 30.
Where I've got sweat dripping off my chin. Yeah. not even a drink is helping you. Shoulders. Oh, 30 seconds. Stay in the work, come on. Concentrate. It's very easy to let your mind go into different places now. You start to get tired, but that is not going to change you. 35 minutes in. We're there. We feel it. You can see. You can see that we are right there with you. Just get another couple of reps out. All of mine came from now on. It's a bit like 8 times 8, or it's a bit like reps. when you get to that point where your body wants to give up, but you've got to get your mind right. In terms of how heavy we are going here, the types of exercise we're doing to hit the muscles we're trying to hit,
same.
This is exactly what you need to be doing.
Yeah. So if you're doing this religiously with us, your body is going to change.
Absolutely.
However, it's what you put in your gob that's important. Oh. I've told you this before.
That has a difference, yeah.
Don't put rubbish in here.
Whatever you put in here fuels you, builds you, powers you. If you're putting crap in it, that's what you're going to get out. It's just straight facts. So think about that. If you're putting in this much effort like we are, and you're absolutely gassed, don't go and eat rubbish, because then you're just hindering all of this work. You might as well not do it. Yeah. So we want to change your body, we want to do it with you, and we want to make sure that when you're posting your pictures, you're like, oh my God, this was so hard.
Yeah.
And we want to make sure that when you leave, you feel like you've had a workout, not just, yeah, it was all right. I mean, I sweated, and I was a bit tired. You want to be like, my legs are broken, because that's what we're working.
We don't want you to come away thinking, I've just done one of those virtual workouts. You know, when there's virtual workouts in a gym where you've watched a screen and you've gone through the motions and you probably could have got a bit heavier and you probably could have done a bit more, but you did it. So that must count for something. We don't want that. We want you to be tired. We want you to work to your absolute maximum, and we want you to keep pushing week in, week out, because that is exactly what we do. We're leading by example. We're doing exactly what we're asking you to do. Yeah,
you can tell that we're tired because we're both talking quite a lot to get out of going through the next round, which is exactly what we're doing.
I'm ready.
No, I don't think
I'm ready.
I don't think you're quite.
Let's do this.
Just like a nail update, still.
Oh, is it still? Are we still there?
Yeah, still on.
Nail update.
Still on.
So you're with me.
My ponytail is wrenched, Teresa.
Oh, it's gross. I'm really good at the same time.
Listen, someone's on his way.
We're not going to be able to move anything. We're going to be just lay on the floor in a bikini, just flopping around, looking amazing. Nothing's going to move. Oh, you've got another 2.5 each side of that.
Oh, great.
So our bar is 42.5, so 45, about 58 pounds in total.
Brilliant.
Yes.
Yes. So this is your last time through. Push yourself. If you've been cutting your reps in your head and not really listening to what we've been about, get one more rep in this last time around. Or just get through it.
Either or. I'm just going to get through it. That's my option. Let's go. Oh my God, legs. I'm so sorry.
Let's have it then. Let's do it.
Big.
back me. This altered your weight. You've got a tiny bit heavier for your last time around.
You know all those memes, those leg day memes? This is the workout that they use for it. You know the one where you just go falling down the stairs? This is the one. I can see tomorrow. Just even bending down is going to be an issue. 30 seconds. Every rep you do is one more rep to the end. It's an hour of your day. That's it. If you're going to put an hour in, you might as well put it in. I mean, let's be honest, you might as well just put it within, aren't you? Why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you? I mean, you can do anything if you want. You could just, you know. Do you want to pay £36 for a spin class?
Goblet squats are next. I'm going to turn my toes out slightly for my last set. So I'm going to hit my inner thighs a little bit more.
Not a rest. Let's go.
Sit back, chest up, drive through heels, squeeze your glutes under. Spot on before you start. Right. stress for your wrist and your grip.
But sometimes it's good to do it without your straps because grip is super important. You're a bit stronger through your forearms.
True, very true.
I don't tend to tell you to use them all the time. Because nobody's giving you straps when you go shopping, are they? 15.
constantly, on every rep, every set, if you train on your own.
I'd definitely give up on the second round on my own.
Would you? This round is very, very real.
10.
Mind on it, mind to muscle connection, and make it work as hard as you can to get it to get better to make it improve, but it also ties and fatigues a little bit quicker. I get it. I own it. I'm all right with it. I just keep driving through it. 12, last 10. All right, then we're done. Oh. Don't stop. 5, 4, 3. Okay.
Oh.
Tension.
Tension, bit of dramatics. What are you going to do? Of course you're going to stay. Aren't you? Have you got time?
Is that moving? Sorry. Sorry if it's moving.
Sorry if it's wobbling a bit.
Apple batteries are rubbish.
Okay, so we're going to do these 4 reps. They're not very long. You've got a couple of minutes to spare. Get them in while you're nice and warm. You've worked through your glutes, you've worked through your posterior chain, the bottom of your back, so you're nice and warm. Everything's lubricated, so let's get them in. So we've got 20 reps of bridges. And then we're going to isolate those legs. So we're going to do
word.
A single.
What?
Which?
Don't use that word.
What? The word you used, don't use.
Which
that
one?
The word you just used. I'm not saying it's just
lubricated.
Don't say that.
It's true though.
No need for that.
It's true.
Everything's about that. Anyway, so we're then going to do single leg bridges. 10 reps on each leg. And then we are going to do bridge pulses with our knees pulsing in and out.
I love that. That's my favourite.
20 reps. We're going to go through it twice.
Do we need a bench then each?
Yes.
Okay, so do we need weights or no?
No, let's do body weight. Let's isolate them. And if you want to, actually, for your bridges, if you want to hold a weight on your hips, please do so.
Are we going to?
Yeah, of course we are.
What would you like?
Let's have a mid-12. When you're doing your single leg bridges, obviously it's going to rock your balance slightly. So if you are holding a weight on your hips, if you're struggling, you can't get your hips up to do a decent bridge, put the weight down and focus on the actual work as opposed to just trying to make it harder, okay? If holding a weight, it means that you can't actually do the exercise, just drop that weight. You're going to be tired now, you've been going for an hour. This is all extra, it's all for free.
Okay, it's 10 okay?
Okay, so we're going to do 20 reps, bridges, and then we're going to do one leg for 10, the other leg for 10, and then we're going to come up back into that bridge position, and we're going to do 20 pulses, knees coming out, squeezing in for our inner and outer thighs as well.
All extra,
all for free.
It's not going to take that long. 4 minutes?
Yeah, it's not going to take long at all. We're going to just blast through these.
I mean, you know.
All nice and close, right? Find a position, do one without pulling your weight first. Find a position where you can do a good bridge. You want to be able to drive through your heels. Don't push your hips through any more than is what your natural extension. And if you can, really focus on squeezing those glutes under your bum cheeks. If you want to start to work your quads a little bit in this, think about squeezing those knees together, but don't let them touch. That will create some tension through your quads. Why not?
I'm not going to do that.
Okay. side of paws all the way back down. Two. When you bring yourself back down, try and roll that back onto the mat so it's completely flat. Squeeze up. Six. Eight. Squeeze and pause. Ten.
You're doing awesome. Keep going. Should be burning.
12. 14. You'll feel these on the back of your legs as well, your hamstrings. With all that you work you've done, two more. And again. Have a rest. So we are now going to isolate and do one leg. So we're going to give it a go with the weight, but like I said, if actually holding the weight is more work and you can no longer actually do that workout well, do that exercise well, drop the weight. Trust me, you're going to be working hard enough with no weight at all. Let's go. Squeeze up with a pause and back down. 10 reps, two. Make sure these are good. On that.
like dead posh. Get one of them, yeah, get one of those posh things. So we are done. And I am done. I'm so done. Let us know what you think.
It's a serious workout.
Yeah. Tell us your calories. Tell us how you got on. Loved it. See you again.